Hello guys, and welcome to Augmented Podcast. We're a podcast staged to discuss, debate, and deliberate on contemporary social, legal, and political issues. However, this is not a podcast, this is going to be an explainer video on cryptocurrency and its legal status. I'm pretty sure you're used to seeing Joel and Maria doing these videos, but you'll have to work with me for now. Coming to the first subheading, what is cryptocurrency? Cryptocurrency is a digital or virtual currency that is heavily backed by cryptography for its security. This cryptography is so detailed and so complex that it makes it virtually impossible to hack, counterfeit, or double spend. Another important feature of cryptocurrency is it's not issued by a central regulatory monetary authority like the RBI we have in India. And what this means is that it's free from government interference and government manipulation. Cryptocurrencies also heavily rely on blockchain technology for their security. Blockchain technology is basically a network that is distributed over a vast system of computers. And this blockchain technology basically allows transactions to be recorded and duplicated, but not be edited. And what this means is that this ledger system or this transaction can be duplicated across the whole system and can be recorded as a series of transactions, but nobody can hack or edit this information. And this is one of the features of cryptocurrency that makes it reliable and makes it a worthwhile investment for many people. Cryptocurrencies have proliferated so much over the past few years that on May 27, 2021, cryptocurrencies were estimated to have a value of $1.7 trillion in total. And this value is expected to continuously rise over the next few decades. Before we move forward, let's talk about the history of cryptocurrency in brief. In the history of cryptocurrency, Bitcoin plays a major role. Bitcoin was the first and is the most valued cryptocurrency in the world today. Earlier attempts were made to create cryptocurrency much before Bitcoin was created in 2008, but this cryptocurrency ran into several problems due to its centralized nature. The man behind creating cryptocurrency is Satoshi Nakamoto. His goal was to create a peer-to-peer crash system having a decentralized nature. He created a decentralized system with no governing or central body. The essence of this system is complete consensus of all parties involved. Every single user or entity needs to agree on every single account balance and transaction for it to work. Cryptocurrency in Bitcoin is advancing as we speak, and there are more developments to come. A word that is synonymous with Bitcoin and cryptocurrency is mining. Mining is the process that involves the use of complex computers to solve large and complicated mathematical problems due to their complex nature cannot be solved by hand. And this process results in two things. Firstly, this process results in the generation and creation of new Bitcoin and new cryptocurrency in the system. And secondly, this process helps maintain the blockchain system involved in cryptocurrency. The miners ensure the trustworthiness and security by verifying the transactional information involved. In this next section, we will be talking about money and cryptocurrency and the similarities that they share. Money has three major functions. It acts as a medium of exchange, it has a measure of value, and has a store of value. Now we'll be going in depth as to what these functions mean. By being a medium of exchange, money possesses the characteristic that allows it to be used in transactions in our day-to-day lives. Money can be used to buy and sell goods, and this is what medium of exchange means. Secondly, when money is said to have measure of value, money can be used as a standard to measure the differences in value between different goods and services. Let's say, for example, there is a good that is priced at rupees 1000. And there is a good that is priced at rupees 500, and there is a good that is priced at rupees 10. We now know that the good priced at rupees 1000 is far more valuable than the good priced at rupees 500 or rupees 10. And this is one of the functions that money performs. And the third and last function is money has a store of value. In order to understand this concept, we need to go back to the barter system when it existed. So the barter system is when goods and services were traded and there was no standardized system of buying and selling goods and services. So this posed the problem of having store of value. So when rice was exchanged for a cow or something like that, rice had a limited period as to when it would be stored. And this proposed the problem of having a store of value. Money eliminates this problem by having a store of value. And what this means is that money can be stored over a prolonged period of time and there will be no damage in the value of money, and money can be used for future payments or as understood as standard for deferred payments. Many argue that cryptocurrency and money share these similarities and as to why cryptocurrency can be understood. Now we'll be talking about cryptocurrencies and their legal status across the world. At the outset, it is important to understand that there's a difference between cryptocurrencies being considered legal and being considered and having the status of a legal tender. Cryptocurrencies being legal means that there's no restriction on their buying, selling, trading, and mining. On the other hand, a legal tender is a financial instrument that is recognized by the laws and the central monetary authority as something that can be used to fulfill financial commitments in the country. For example, the Indian rupee in India is the legal tender accepted in the country. Moving forward, to understand the legal status of cryptocurrencies across the world, we can bracket them into three different categories. One, where cryptocurrencies have been made legal tender. Two, where cryptocurrencies are regulated by the financial authority in the country. And three, where cryptocurrencies have been completely banned. Under the first category, for now, there is only one country that falls under this, and it is El Salvador. In El Salvador, recently, bitcoins were made legal tender by a bill that was proposed and passed in the parliament. And Paraguay is working towards developing and proposing a bill in his parliament as well. The second category is where cryptocurrencies are regulated by their financial and monetary authority. And under this category falls Japan. In Japan, cryptocurrencies, the transactions involved, are regulated by their financial and monetary authority. And cryptocurrencies are considered to be private property and are also taxed. In the third category, where cryptocurrencies have been completely banned and any activities, including buying, selling, and trading, have been completely banned, are countries like Morocco and Nepal. And also recently, when China had banned mining and banned the buying and selling of cryptocurrencies in its jurisdiction. And this also led to a huge fall in the market share and the value of cryptocurrencies across the world, as 70% of cryptocurrency mining is based in China. Many crypto miners were forced to move to other countries in order to continue their mining. And there was an instance where cryptocurrency miners were recorded moving to Kazakhstan to continue their crypto mining. In India, in 2018, the Reserve Bank of India, which is the central monetary authority, had issued a notification stating that any financial institutions like banks and other financial institutions associated with the RBI cannot take part in any transactions involved with cryptocurrencies, which including buying, selling, and trading. This greatly affected the cryptocurrency market in India. And in response to this, a writ petition was filed in the Supreme Court. And in 2020, the Supreme Court quashed the notification stating that it is unconstitutional, as cryptocurrencies do not have and affect the legal tender, which is in India, and therefore doesn't affect the economy of India, and the RBI has no business to interfere in this matter. Of late, cryptocurrency has also been undertaking another development in India as a new cryptocurrency bill is being proposed in the parliament. And if this bill is passed, it would ban all private cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Dogecoin, and other cryptocurrencies. And the RBI would issue a central cryptocurrency known as a digital rupee, which would be controlled and monitored by the RBI. Well, that brings us to the end of this video. I hope you guys liked it and found it informative. What are your views on cryptocurrency? Do you think it should be made legal tender? Or do you think the government is right in banning all private cryptocurrencies? Do let us know in the comment section down below. Argumento is available on Spotify, IGTV, YouTube, and Apple Music. Stay tuned for more.